Nigeria, the youth have been harassed. People killing, people dying, shouldn't hurt you, hear I'm crying. Can you practice what you preach, what you tell?
We demand real representation.
I'm just glad I'm here today, and I'm hoping that this is not in vain. As you know, this program is alive, so, you know, it's more than a hashtag. Guys. Incredible. Everyone came out today for a peaceful protest.
What have they even done? What have they done?
Just because I dye my hair, just because we have dreads, just because we're looking French, it does not mean we're criminals. No mother, no father, no family should be made to cry because of the loss of their child at the hands of the people that are supposed to be protecting us. And I believe that this whole thing is much deeper than sand. I believe that the rock is deeper than sand. It goes all the way into the promised. It goes all the way to the decision making. So right now, what do we want?
Out of what's happening right now.
Yeah, what I think is Nigerian government only responds to international embarrassment. For the past few days, they've been talking about NSAS. No media outlet is actually carried it in Nigeria. But I feel like now that there's international support and movement, a lot of Nigerian government are going to respond, and hopefully our voices will be heard and they're going to end NSAS.
Last year, we were protesting the Nigerian police because they were arresting women outside in Abuja. They were raping women, arresting them, and saying that because they were prostitutes, they were allowed to do that to those women. And we came out here and we protested. And it's just so important for me to say that it was a women's issue at the time, so the turnout was mostly women. So I'm happy that we can all come out here now and understand what it means to stand toe to toe, men and women, fighting for the same thing. And I really, really hope that next time when we call people and we say, come out, even if it's a women's issue, if it's a men's issue, even if it's nobody's issue, LGBTQ, let everybody always speak up because we deserve our rights as Nigerians.
Thank you.
So the NSAS is a movement right now. Let's not stop it here. Let's get out and vote. Let's get out and go to the polls. Like, I know this, by being in diaspora, there's many offices, there's many platforms, there's many places where we can go to let our voices be heard. But we also have to vote. It's more important to vote than just be chanting NSAS, because we are the ones that kick the people out of the office. You get what I'm saying?
I mean, it makes me feel very good that people who don't even live in Nigeria, people who don't go to Nigeria quite often, they are all out here. You know, people are out, everyone is protesting.
Right now, on my way here, the IDP in Nigeria has disbanded, sir.
To the original Odogwu of Nigeria, go, sir! Go, sir! Go, sir! Go, sir! Go, sir! Okay, guys, SARS has been disbanded! SARS has been disbanded, and now
your voice has been heard. This is a new Nigeria. We are not scared to speak our mind against bad government. And as I speak to you right now, on my way here, the IDP in Nigeria and disbanded, sir. So Nigerian youth, don't let anyone tell you you don't have a voice. You won't have a voice.